Let's do some more work with rational expressions. So let's say I had a squared plus 2ab plus b squared, and all of that is over ab squared minus a squared b. And we're going to take this and divide it by, a plus b, So the first thing we might want to do is just factor this numerator and this denominator, and then we could divide, or actually we could go the other way. We could divide and then factor. So if we divide and then factor, we could say, well, this is the same thing. This is equal to this whole expression. Let me just copy and paste it. That's probably the easiest thing to do. Let me copy and then paste it. It's equal to that expression times the inverse of this. If I divide by something, that's the same thing. That's the same thing as multiplying by the inverse, as multiplying by 1 over a plus b. And this is just going to be the same thing as, with a plus b in the denominator, because your numerator is going to be that times 1, which is just that. Your denominator is going to be ab squared minus a squared b times a plus b, so that times a plus b. So this would be a legitimate answer, but I have a suspicion that this can be further simplified. So let's see if we can simplify it. So our numerator here, a squared plus 2ab plus b squared, you might recognize that. That is a perfect square. That is our numerator. Let me color code it. So that numerator right there, that is the same thing as a plus b squared, or a plus b times a plus b, because you have a squared, you have a b squared, and then you have 2 times a and b right in the middle. That is a perfect square. Multiply it out if you don't believe me. So that numerator is that right there. And then the denominator, what is this? Well, let's see what happens if we factor out an ab down here. So let's factor out an ab. So ab squared divided by ab, a cancels out. You're just left with ab, right? Ab times b is ab squared. And then minus a squared b divided by ab is just a, This right here is the same thing as that. And you could multiply it out. Ab times negative a is negative a squared b. You got that right there. So multiply it out, you should get this right there. And of course, you also have your a plus b sitting here. Now, we have an a plus b squared in the numerator. We have an a plus b in the denominator. We could say a plus b to the first power. And then we know our exponent rules here. We can just essentially cancel out an a plus b in the numerator and the denominator, which decrements this exponent by 1, so this just becomes a 1, and then this becomes a 0, or it cancels out. And so we get this is being equal to a plus b over ab over ab times b minus a, with the caveat, because we canceled this thing out in the denominator, we have to say, look, this thing can still not equal 0, because this will still make this expression undefined. We have to say the only way that this is going to be equal to 0 is if we subtract b from both sides, a is equal to negative b. So we have to add the caveat that a cannot be equal to negative b. We have to add this condition. And so this is our answer. Let's do another one. Let's do a more involved one, just to really get our juices flowing. Let's say we have x squared plus 8x plus 16 divided by or over 7x squared plus 9x plus 2 divided by 7x over 4 over x squared plus 4x. So what is this going to be equal to? So here we could divide first. That's the same thing as multiplying by the inverse of this thing. But just for fun, let's factor these two, the numerator and the denominator here. So this numerator over here, that's pretty straightforward. That is a perfect square. That is x plus 4 squared. 4 times 4 is 16. 4 plus 4 is 8. So our numerator is x plus 4. X plus 4 squared. And then our denominator, what does that become? Here we're going to have to do a little bit of grouping. We're going to have to do a little bit of grouping to factor that out. So we have 7x squared plus 9x plus 2. We have to find two numbers. When I multiply them, I get 7 times 2, which is equal to 14. And when I add them, a plus b need equal 9. And the easiest two numbers are 7 and 2. So let's rewrite this. This is the same thing as 7x squared. I'll group the 7x with the 7, because they have a common factor of 7, plus 7x plus 2x plus 2. Put parentheses around there so you can see the grouping. Factor out a 7x over here, you get 7x times x plus 1, plus factor out a 2 here, 2 times x plus 1, and you get the 7x plus 2. 7x plus 2 times your x plus 1. We're undistributing that expression. So this is our denominator right there. This is our denominator. So, and actually, I just realized that I made a slight error when I wrote down this problem. The numerator here is actually 7x plus 2, lucky for us. Obviously, this is going to lead to interesting things later on, potentially. So let's see what we get. And actually, I think there's a typo here. I think this is supposed to be a 4x, just a 4. So let me just put it like that, just in case that is a typo, because I think it's going to make it more interesting. So that's our original problem. We haven't messed with this part yet, so it won't change any of our math. But so far, we factored this bottom part using grouping as 7x plus 2 times x plus 1. And so this expression is the exact same thing as this expression over here. And we're going to divide it by that expression. So dividing by that expression, that is the same exact thing as multiplying by the inverse of this expression. By the inverse of this expression. Oh, actually, you know what? I just realized that it wasn't x squared plus 4x. I just saw the problem. That is an x squared plus 4x. So this was the original problem. Sorry for all of that. But we haven't done any work here, so it's all cool. So this right over here, multiplying by the inverse of this, we multiply. Dividing by this is the same thing as multiplying by the inverse. So we just flip the numerator and the denominator. So x squared plus 4x over 7x plus 2. And then another thing we can do, let's see, if we look at this up here, we can factor out an x. So this right here, if we factor out an x, is the same thing as x times x plus 4. So if we do all of the multiplication, what does our numerator become? We have x, let me do it in a new color. We have x plus 4 squared times x plus 4. That is our numerator. And our denominator is 7x plus 2 times another 7x plus 2. Times an x plus 1. So here nothing is canceling out, but we have the same term being multiplied multiple times. X to the fourth squared times x to the fourth to the first power. This is going to be equal to, we still have our x out front, so it's x times x plus 4, we could say to the third power. All of that over, we have 2 7x's plus 2, so 7x plus 2 squared times x plus 1. And we are done.